The if function allows you to change the action that Excel performs based on some predefined condition. In this segment, you'll learn how to activate and use the if function. In this example, we have a number of bank accounts with their current balances. We'd like to work out the interest charge, but depending on what the balance is, the interest rate is different. So if it's a positive number, we'll get the deposit interest rate of 8%, but if we're negative or in overdraft, we'll be charged at 12%. We can use Excel's if function to do this calculation. So you click on the cell where you want the answer, activate the function wizard, and find the if function, and say OK. And what it asks is, what is the logical test? So in this case, we are saying is, if this number is bigger than zero, then it says what happens. If it's true that that is bigger than zero, what must it do? And in this case, it must take that number and multiply it by the deposit interest rate. We'll make it absolute. If it is false, then we can assume that it must be less than zero, in which case it must take the current balance and multiply it by the overdraft interest rate. And when you click OK and copy it down, you'll see that what Excel has done is it has looked at the balance, in this case 100, and realized it's a deposit interest rate, and so it's given 8. But when it's a negative balance and an overdraft, the interest is more expensive, and therefore it is 12. And similarly with the other calculations.